Okay, Sonia has a follow-up. Thank you for what I had previously said. I'll check out the ultimate cheat sheet and look for values that are proportionally out of range from the adult values. This is going back to the question about the child with unusual fatigue. I'm still confused about those might need to be proportionally different. Well, yeah, they might need to be, but there's not much you can do because there aren't childhood based ranges that are data driven. I'll re-listen to your answer later to see if there is something I missed. I also pay special attention to organic acids and amino acids. Kids are tricky due to picky eating. You know, one thing I'd add here is that so what if the ranges are need to be a little bit different in children? The approach in the cheat sheet is not to rely exclusively on the ranges. It's also to look at the diet and lifestyle analysis and to look at the signs and symptoms. So what you do is you piece together. Does the diet and lifestyle analysis, the blood lab, and the signs and symptoms all say deficiency X, too much Y? Then that's very good information. And what you do is you intervene on the basis of what seems probable and you monitor the outcome. So you're not making an assumption on the blood range, and it's okay that the blood range might not give you the exact right information.